Hello, all of you vaingloriously wonderful people, and welcome back to Timberborn, where it looks like these dudes are empty. Yeah, we can get rid of those guys, and that finishes off that. What I'd like to do real quick is maybe investigate some more storage. It seems that the guys that live over here keep going to bed hungry, and as well as some people over here. We may need to visit some housing over here. That might be a thing that would benefit us greatly. But for now, I think we're doing good. You know, I'm going to get rid of these two. We don't need these little guys. And I'm going to get rid of that builder's hut because it's kind of just in the way at the moment. Plus, I don't need a builder's hut at the moment. I think what I would like to have is maybe just a few more water pumps. Just because we are getting a little low on the old water. So we're just gonna squeeze in a couple more right there. Run our path right like that. And that'll get us just a couple more water pumps to help get all of this full. Because as it is, we don't even have one of these full yet. This one they're starting to put in, but still. I'd like to get them nice and full. So that we just have massive, massive amounts of water on reserve. We are starting to get some bread, which is awesome. Granted, we only have the one bakery, and it looks like they only make, like, well, if they're working an 18-hour day, they're going to be able to get, what, 36 bread done? No, they make times five, so 150, 180 bread per day. So I don't know why we don't have more than that. In fact, it may be that they're not getting enough wheat flour. That could be the problem. What I'm wondering is, do we have any maple syrup yet? We do not, but we do have pine resin. So I want to come over here and see in this area, is there anywhere we could squeeze in the ability, wow, we're running low on logs all of a sudden. Oof. Granted, we did just have a massive, massive building project. And we're also using logs here. So hopefully those logs will come back. And look at them gather that resin. Good deal. And it looks like that's a good size area because there's only this one tree back here in the corner that they can't get to anyway. That is... You got any resin on it? Yeah, nobody can get to that tree. That tree's been there forever. It'll never get cut down. It's just in the corner. And then over here, you have... So you still don't... You're getting close to having maple syrup on. I mean, you're at 98%. And then once they have it, they have it. And they can start scraping it. And it comes back pretty quick. I think the same with the pine resin, that it comes back fairly quick. But what I'd like to do is see about starting to make the treated wood, which we do that wood workshop. Yeah, strengthens planks by infusing them with resin. Oh, it needs a lot of power. Ooh. And we are not ready to do that yet. So instead, we made a paper mill, right? I think we made a paper mill. Did we make a paper mill anywhere? I'm gonna say no, cause we're not making any. Look at that. We have maple syrup. So maybe a paper mill is what we need next. 80 power required for a paper mill. So I think what we could do is maybe squeeze it in right here or right, let's go right here. And then, let's see, you are powered by that windmill, which is, you require how much, lumber mill? 50? And you require 80. So 130, you only make 50. Okay, yeah, that's not gonna work then. So we're only like two windmills just to power this dude. So hold on, let's move where he is. Hold on, stop it, stop building. I know. I really like to build the large one, but we can't until we make what we're working on now. Okay, so we put one here, and then we're gonna use this. Or does that not work? How does this work exactly? Well, it should work. So that doesn't work like that. It would have to have the path. Okay, so I need to move this path too. All right. You can move the path. That's not a big deal. And delete. And delete. Cool. And now let's see about getting this dude right here to go up and over. There we go. And then bring it back down. And then hopefully be able to get... So how do I get, do I have to build a platform for it to sit on? Guessing so. So we put that there, and then this can sit up there and connect those two. Cool. There we go. And then we can build our paper mill right there. And that's immediately connected to that. And then we can build a second, because again, that's only 50. Well, I'd say it's 115. Wait, how much does this do they put out? Oh, 200. What was I worried about then? This could have powered it. I could have just split that off. Oh, well. It's connected now in a very intricate, interesting looking way. So I'm going to leave it because I like it. And we can put something else right there. In fact, I think that something else is going to be a bit of storage. No, I guess not. Because nothing fits. That's fine. I still need to get up here. I'd like to get up there and do something with all of that. I just think it's an interesting looking bit of land. I'd really think we would do well to investigate it. So we have 22 wheat flour. Is it because the wheat is just taking a long time to grow? Yeah, because we've burned through all the wheat that we had stored, and I don't think this stuff has actually made it through a growth cycle yet. Also, oh, we don't have paper to make that guy. Well, we'll have it eventually. We're building that right now. Woo, okay, I've clicked outside of the window here again. Cool, our paper mill is up and running, so we are going to have paper now. Which will enable us to make even cooler, better things. Which I think one of them was what? What were we going for with paper mill? I've forgotten. Gear Workshop printing press. We could do a printing press and make books, because books make our little beavers happy. Where can we fit that in here anywhere? Just nearby, so that we're not really like wasting space. We put it over here. That's not too far away. How much power do you need? 150. Yeah, let's make some books. Let's do it. I think that'll be exciting. Put that there. And then we will run a shaft out of there. And then we'll turn the corner like that. Am I turning that corner properly? Let's see. Aerial view. Yeah, there we go. So they should be able to build that, because again, oh no, that needs metal blocks. We don't have metal blocks. All right, just delete all this. There's no reason in building it, because we can't do it yet. Dang, that makes me sad. Okay, I should have paid attention to that. So what else? What else? I wonder if we had, well no, it's not a, wheat is our holdup. It's not the lack of grist mills. So I don't even think it's a lack of bakeries, but we could build a beehive, which will give us, what, honey? I don't know. How big? Oh, these are tiny. Let's go. Do we have paper in storage yet? We have some. Let's do it. Do these have a, yeah. Why? Boost the growth of nearby crops. Oh, I didn't know that's what they did. Ooh, okay. Let's rethink this then. They don't need to go there. Yeah, that's not where those need to go. What we need to do is like clear, like in the middle. Okay, so what's the radius? I can't quite tell. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 by 7. Okay. So one of these would. So that's one. Here, hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh my god. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Nice. So then if I come straight down and there, if I get rid of that one, that should be right in the middle. There they go. And then come in here with that guy. Look at that. Perfect. Perfection. And then come out. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. And then 1, 2, 3. There, next to this dude. He just increases aesthetics, but that's okay. I'd like to leave him there. Anyway, when they're out in the fields working, they're like, hey, look, he's pretty. So right next to that dude, we want to remove resources. Like that. Thought maybe the game was paused, but no, it's just nighttime. And then over here, we could boost all of this, but we're not going to be able to get it all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we go like right there. That'll get most of this area. All right, you should be clear over here. Yep. Man, I didn't know that's what beehives did. That's freaking awesome. And then we're not gonna miss just a little bit down here, but that's okay. So are they able to get there? They are able to get there to build it, so that's good. We've got paper being produced. That's freaking cool. So then let's drop this dude in here. So it says nearby crops. So I'm going to assume it doesn't do anything for my wood because those aren't crops. That's a whole trees and bushes and crops are two totally different things. So I'm not even going to bother with them near all of that, but I am going to try to get a few in over here. So again, I'm not going to go completely completely covered. So then 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then we'll move that back some there. And we'll do like another one there. And then we'll do like one about there. And then another one about there. And that'll cover almost all my crops except for up here. And we'll do one there. And we'll do one there. Okay, cool. So they are getting those cleared out so we can plop those into place. A little bit of overlap. I'm okay with that. There we go. And there and there. Was there anywhere else that I needed to plant one? Plant one? Build one? We're planting beehives. Watch them grow. All right. So that was a lot that we just asked of our paper mill. He hasn't even finished or produced enough paper for this one yet. So there's only two paper in storage right now, but we'll get there. And the nice thing is that should help our crops grow faster. Hopefully the bees don't attack the beavers. Hopefully they're nice bees. Oh, look at those bees. Well, those look like wonderfully nice bees. I don't think those bees would harm a single hair on a beaver's head. Nah, those are lovely bees. Also, you can see like the cell shading once you zoom in really nice and close like this. It's kind of pretty. It's kind of nice. Just watch the bees do their thing. So yeah, cool. Bees. So I wonder if that's going to like ramp up how much wheat we're really getting. I want to keep an eye on these numbers. Got a lot of pine resin. We are getting maple syrup. As we get maple syrup, I could maybe throw in a second bakery. I mean, I know we don't have the Oh, you go that way. Oof. Okay, well, that's fine because I can get a road right there. Or a path. Do that. We don't really have the wheat for this, but I think it uses a little less wheat if I set it to the one that makes rolls. We're going to see here. We still have a lot of gear and a lot of planks in stock, but we don't have a whole lot of logs. And remember, I said I was going to try to make logs or a forest down here. So we're going to delete that building. And we are indeed going to. We're going to delete that as well, because I want to get rid of those stairs and replace them here. Wait, it's a little more efficient. So I want to plant trees. So we have a couple new trees. We have a new tree. We've got the chestnut tree, which takes 24 days to grow versus 30 days for that. Gives us four logs versus eight, so half. But it gives us chestnuts as well, which we can use, I believe, to cook or to roast. Chestnuts roasting, et cetera, et cetera. So I think I want to do chestnut trees all along here. And then back here, do another, what was it? Was it underwood? Where's my guy that gathers sap? Lumberjack, Black, Lumbermill, Forester. Just gonna have to go through them all again. Tapper Shack, there we go. Which I think I can get in right there. Awesome. And then up here, or over here in this corner, we will put one lumberjack flag. And we will put another lumberjack flag right there. Not that I think they'll be able to cut all that down, but hey. And then we will go ahead and go to trees. There we go. And fill in the rest of this with some chestnut. I don't know how that's going to impact our windmill, though. We'll find out. And we'll just leave that bit open. Yeah, I don't know that I like that right against the windmill. Yeah, I don't like that right against the windmill at all. So we're going to say clear planting area right there. There we go. So you are here to gather. Oh, okay. How do we gather chestnuts then? I think I know. I think it's this guy. Yeah, it's this guy. Okay. Cool. Hey, that gives us extra space for a few more trees. So chestnut. Awesome. Cool. Buildings are connected to the district by any paths. What? What are you on about? Wait, do I saw that district gate in? No. What? Prioritize chestnuts. Nothing doing range. I know. That's because the chestnuts haven't grown in. What do you mean you are not in range? You're on crack is what. You're totally in range. Do this, and we'll see if maybe we can just kind of like convince it that, yeah, this is connected to the district. Yeah, I got rid of the district gate. We tore that down a long time ago. I thought, what does the district gate look like? Yeah, it's actually a physical gate. I would see it right here. So we don't have this separated out as a separate district. But man, it sure is acting like it. That's really bizarre that that's saying the building is connected. And then we put that in and it's still saying it. Did I build it backwards? Is that the problem? I may have built it backwards. Let's rebuild it. That is entirely possible that I built it backwards. Okay, the arrow's pointing that way, so we should be good there. Construction lacks materials. What construction is that? Oh, just these beehives. It'll take them a while to get all the beehives done. So they've just now finished this one. Oh, look at that wheat. Oh, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. There we go. And now we should start getting, more wheat flour. Which one of these is our actual wheat? There we go. Yeah. We're actually making some wheat flour now. So hopefully we'll see even more bread being produced. This guy is, not that one. My bad. Go back. Bread, you are going to make maple pastries, which requires one wheat flour and one maple syrup to make three pastries. Maple pastries. That sounds delicious. This still says it is not connected. Oh, wait, is that too far out? Is that the problem? Is that what's going on? Yep. Okay. All right. Okay. That's understood. So we will delete right there. And then we will delete this. And we will put it here. Okay. It was just too far. I can't believe I didn't realize that to begin with. So yeah, that's kind of the end of this district going this way. I don't have, no matter what, I have no way of getting to go any farther. So this will have to be a new district out this direction. So maybe we could do like our district center and have it really close and then just build a bridge over. Or maybe do the district center like over here. Because once you can just plop a district center. Like, I can just place one right there and it'll be ready to go. So maybe that's what we'll do is plop down. Though I don't know if it'll let me do it until I build a gate. No, it will. I can. So, yeah, maybe we have our next district center just, like, right around there. Cool. Granted, nobody lives there. You know, it's also District 3 because we had a District 2 earlier and tore it down. What's your problem? Nothing to do in range. Well, you know what we don't have out here? I know why these trees aren't growing. Because I'm a genius is why. Let's come in here and we need a forester, which is a 2x2 building. Let's just plop it on top of some of these trees here. There we go. Of course, they're not growing because he can't plant anything anywhere. You know what we could do? We could do a tiny little bit of berries maybe there. How far do you reach? I'll have to wait till you're built to find out because you're not showing me this way. So yeah, hopefully now we can get this connected. We're going to have to do some stuff and things, obviously, to make that all work. I know that's very technical. While we are holding 2,000 water, and these aren't even all full. Woohoo! Nice. Our resources are definitely ticking up. That looks beautiful. Not a whole lot of maple syrup there, so I don't know if this bakery is really going to see a whole lot of action. But, hopefully we'll get there. So let's make you high priority. Let's get you done and get you planting those chestnuts. So prioritize chestnut tree. There we go. Now we'll get those trees planted. So yeah, the wheat came along really nicely with the help of our bee friends, didn't it? I'm really pleased with that. We've got these bees over here helping out, and then we'll eventually get some over this general direction. I think before we do a new district, though, we need to work on some housing and some other things over here, because we've kind of focused a lot of it all over here, and people are having to walk pretty far to go to work. They've got a lot of paths to do so, but they're still having to go a fairly long distance to get to their workplaces. So I think we would do well to address that by giving them a bit of housing up there. I'd like to have about 200 beavers unemployed before we start a new district anyway. That way I can just send just a huge workforce over to just start tackling everything. But that's all, you know, stuff for a future video. What we want to do here is look at the result of our paper mill has built both a scarecrow and a beehive. Yes, I forgot what it was called. I had to click on it. Anyways, guys, that's going to do it. So until next time, I'm Brandon, reminding you to stay vainglorious.